Hello and welcome to ScamWatch, your current source of news, tips and information highlighting the scams and frauds impacting seniors, families, businesses and consumers on Vancouver Island. I'm Roslyn Scott, President and CEO of the Vancouver Island Better Business Bureau.
Now I'm Constable Catherine Coulthart with the RCMP Federal Commercial Crime Section. This week we are talking about charitable giving scams. It seems across the globe there have been an ongoing number of natural disasters with huge impacts on local communities and entire countries. Even locally, the recent period of tough economic times for many families, businesses, governments, and nonprofit organizations has resulted in many charities needing to dramatically increase their fundraising efforts.
Unfortunately, this is also the perfect environment for scam artists to try and trick sympathetic donors into giving to fake charities. They will quite often use holiday seasons, natural disasters, or the state of the economy to trick people into impulsively giving to causes they know little or nothing about, or perhaps even giving private information so that they can be a victim of identity theft later on. Catherine, I understand that recently in Salmon Arm, the RCMP issued a press release and a warning to the general public about a charitable giving scam in that area. In the scam, people were going door to door, claiming to be from a reputable charity. They were selling gift cards, and they had a point of sale machine with them, a handheld point of sale machine. And people could pay by debit or credit card. However, the scam was they were not from a reputable charity, and the machine was skimming their credit card and debit card information.
Yes, this was a fairly simple and yet technically sophisticated scam. In fact, from what I understand, the victims were even given printed receipts. The scammers used the fake point-of-sales machines to steal bank account numbers and PIN numbers from donors for the purposes of identity theft. Several thousands of dollars were stolen from victims in Salmon Arm.
While we haven't heard specifically of this scam reaching our community, it is a mobile and potentially very threatening scam, and we urge the general public to be on the lookout and report it to the police immediately if you come across this type of scam. But this is just one of the many differing types of charity scams that we hear about, isn't it, Catherine?
Yes, frauds under the guise of charity come in a variety of forms, but many contain some similar elements. Generally, be aware of solicitations for donations that involve claims that 100% of donations assist victims. All charities have fundraising and administrative costs. Even a credit card or text donation will involve at least a processing fee. Don't feel pressured to give your money immediately on the spot. The charities that want your money today will welcome it just as much tomorrow.
There are a few other things that you need to look out for in the form of red flags. A requirement to pay in cash or by check to the individual collecting. After all, a legitimate charity has to have a paper trail for tax purposes, and they would never ask you to do that. The use of names that look impressive or that closely resemble the name of a well-known organization. Many fake or unethical charities will use names similar to those of legitimate ones to trick people into thinking they're dealing with a reputable organization. And finally, the failure to provide you with adequate information or documentation. Legitimate charities will be able to provide you with contact information, detailed explanations of how your funds will be used, financial statements, and answers to all your questions. Beware of appeals that bring tears to your eyes but give you little or no information about the cause that it describes so well.
As it is with most scams, the key to protecting yourself is really to take your time and to do your research before you donate to a cause. Most people fall victims to charitable giving scams when they give on impulse rather than after careful consideration. My suggestion is to plan in advance and decide how much and to who you're going to donate to. This way you're less likely to become a victim.
There's some very practical things you can do to prevent yourself from falling victim to charitable giving scams. Before you donate to any charity, be sure to check out the organization with both the Canadian Revenue Agency and with your Better Business Bureau. The CRA has a database of registered Canadian charities, and the Better Business Bureau has reports and business reviews available on both businesses and charities across North America. Do your research to make sure you understand what percentage of your donation will actually go to the cause versus administrative costs. One of the Better Business Bureau's standards for charitable accountability states that at least 65% should go towards the intended cause. If possible, do not give cash. Always make your contributions by check and the check payable to the charity, not to the individual. and keep records of your donations. That would be receipts, canceled checks, and bank statements, so you can document your charitable giving at tax time.
You will also want to be cautious when giving online to unfamiliar charities. Be wary of spam messages and emails that claim to be from a charity. Many fraudulent websites and organizations are created overnight by scammers after disasters and during the holiday season. If the solicitation is not related to an emergency or immediate disaster relief, consider factors beyond just the emotional appeal. Focus on causes you care and know the most about. Often a larger donation to one charity is more effective than multiple small donations to many. Keep in mind, however, that some charities depend on small donations from a large number of donors, and for many people, smaller donations are a more practical way to give. And we always recommend that if you are targeted by a charitable donation scam that is going on under the name of a reputable charity, such as with the skimming scam in Salmon Arm, that you report the incident immediately to the charity.
The Better Business Bureau has a great online resource called the Wise Giving Alliance. You can check it out at www.give.org. This site has lots of information, tips, and advice on wise giving. But more importantly, it has reviews and reports on charities across North America. They are all evaluated, and you can check to see if they comply to the standards of charity accountability.
If you discover you've been targeted or victimized by a charitable giving scam, be sure to contact your local police department immediately. I also recommend that you file a report with the Canadian Fraud Centre, also known as Phone Busters. If you donate to a charity via debit or credit card, in person or online, we recommend that you carefully monitor your bank statements for any odd transactions. If you think something is wrong or odd, or if you have been taken advantage of, be sure to let your financial institutions know immediately.
The best way to protect yourself from this and any other scam or fraud is to stay informed, use your common sense, and if it sounds too good to be true, usually it is.
For more information on scams and frauds and crimes impacting your region, be sure to visit the Better Business Bureau serving Vancouver Island and your local police websites.
And if you have a personal story or a scam or fraud you'd like us to share on ScamWatch, please send the information to info@vi.bbb.org.